This is the 2012 Aloha Clinic Catch or Incomplete Pass training video. The first play we have was ruled incomplete, and it's a long pass down the sideline. I'm not sure if it was ruled incomplete because the official thought he was out of bounds or because of a bobble or lack of control of the ball. It appears to me that there's a foot in bounds when the ball contacts his hands. So as long as the ball sticks, it's a catch, but it sure looks like there's a bobble there. And in this case, it's appropriate to give the bobble signal and then the incomplete. Play number two, it was ruled a catch. It's a nice job of not rushing your decision. Now, it's a tight play, but he had a good distance visually on the play, and he took his time before he ruled that it was a catch. You can see that the foot is down. It's very close to the sideline. But based on his position and his mechanics, I would say that's a nice call. Play number three involves the end line. The back judge is primary in this call, but the wing official sometimes can help. In this case, the wing official is stationary and has a good look, so if he has anything to add or needs to add, he can. But the call was ruled incomplete. It looks like there's a foot down. I think it's inbounds based on how the field is lined, but I'm not there. And as long as the back judge is in a good position to make that ruling, that's a good call. Nobody's going to argue that. Play number four, end line again. This one is ruled a catch. It's a nice job of waiting it out. You can see that that's a tight, very tough call with a bobble. Now what I like is that the wing official saw that the goal line wasn't threatened and he came down to take a look. You can see this is where he gets possession after the bobble. Looks like he's inbounds. Looks like a great catch. And I'm not sure that the back judge can handle this on his own. And the wing official coming up from the sideline did a nice job. This one, umpire over the middle for a TD. This is a case where you got to make the call. I mean, this is really your situation that you wait for. This is your glory moment. There's a guy that comes right over the middle. Nobody else can really see whether or not this ball is caught. And here you're giving the thumbs up. Now, I know you're used to doing that on other goal line plays. I'd like umpires to just eliminate that entirely. And on passes over the middle, where you're the only one can rule on it, go for the gold, man. Signal touchdown. I think you got a good call there. Starting with play number six, we're going to get into the process of a catch. Now, it's more than just touching your hands and having a toe on the ground. This was ruled a catch and fumble. The receiver never had clear possession of the ball. You can see when it hits him, it goes low, and then the defender hits him, the ball immediately comes out. This is an incomplete pass, and we need to rule it an incomplete pass every time to have consistency in our game. Let's go to the next play, play number seven. This was ruled a catch fumble. Same thing, this is an incomplete pass. So we're going to watch the quarterback set back. He pitches the ball out instantaneously. That receiver's hit. The ball is out, rolling out of bounds at the 34-yard line. And they're spotting it at the 34-yard line as a fumble out of bounds. This is an incomplete pass. Play number eight, ruled catch. It was actually ruled a catch and a fumble. Watch this. This is amazing. We've got to take our time with the call. Where's the ball? It's ruled a touchdown. Where's the ball? I'll show you where the ball is. Right here. That is not a catch and touchdown. That's incomplete. We need to wait and take our time. Play number nine, ruled incomplete. Here's what we want. This is exactly what we want. Great call. Incomplete. Some people would say, oh, that's a catch fumble. It's not. It just touches his hands. He's immediately hit. The ball comes out. Incomplete. Very nice job. And this is what we want throughout all of these plays. Incomplete. Play number 10. This is ruled an interception, but this is incomplete. And this is just a ball that bounces on the ground before a guy gets to it. Now, in this case, it happens kind of fast, sure, and you're probably focused on the receiver, but we have to be able to transition based on where the ball is. And the line judge in this case has a good look at the play, and it's very clear that it bounces off the ground. I think the back judge can help on this too. Do not allow a turnover on this kind of play. Play number 11, it's just a bobble catch. It's good whistle control from the standpoint of the officials. You can see that the ball just hangs around for quite a while. There's a defender that tries to get in there a little bit, but the contact is all legal. The important part about this play is that don't be too quick about blowing your whistle. The ball's all over the place. There you go. Still a catch. Good job. Play number 12 is what I call a takeaway catch. It's when somebody has it and then somebody else gets it. Well, this also falls into line with the process of a catch. In this case, the receiver gets it and it's first down. The defender thought he had an interception. It's in his hands. The receiver just rips it out. Now, in the old days, that would have been a catch. That would have been a catch. But if the ball comes out, it's incomplete in today's world. But in this case, the ball never comes out, so whoever ends up with it is the owner of the ball, and that's a great catch and a great ruling by the officials. Play 13, this is interesting. It's a leg catch. It's just a great lesson in not blowing your whistle too fast, guys. Process the play. This is awesome. Nobody blew their whistle, and you can see he's right there. Ball's going through his legs. It's very tempting to pop your whistle. But the ball never hit the ground. It went right through his legs, and he maintained control of it, and then he was downed, and that's a catch. Fantastic job of maintaining whistle control on this play. Play number 14 was ruled a catch, and it's just a reminder to maintain your focus on the play and not be in too much of a rush to blow whistles or give signals or to move back upfield. You can see he's right up here. He's not watching the players, but guess what? The way that that ball came in, there's no way the official can see the completed catch unless he follows it all the way through and then finds the ball. Because where he's located on the field, he can't see it. So this is just a reminder, before you get too excited about signaling a touchdown or signaling a guy down, is watch the action involved in the play, evaluate it, take your time, and then when you're comfortable with the situation, go ahead and make your ruling with a signal for a touchdown incomplete or marking your progress spot. Play number 15, just another example of not being in a hurry. In this case, it is a touchdown pass and a touchdown catch. But you can see that the wing official on the near side, he's up with that touchdown signal very quickly. In fact, too quickly. So as you watch this play, the receiver's up, he's coming down. It's not a catch until then. So wait on your signal until you've seen the entire action. At this point right now, at the stop frame, he's coming up. It's a touchdown. Doesn't wait it out. If that ball pops out as he's coming down or in the process of coming down or when he hits the ground, incomplete pass. So your hands up in the air signaling touchdown is a little bit embarrassing if our philosophy in all of football from Pop Warner through the NFL is incomplete and you've got your hands up in the air for a touchdown. Play number 16, this is the last clip on this tape, and that's just again a reminder to take your time because this ball bounces around a long time. The officials do a nice job of waiting it out because it ultimately is intercepted after that 1, 2, 3 bounces off of players and then a bobble and then a catch by the defense in the end zone. Nice job of officiating. That's the end of the tape. Thanks again.